Ask Mr. Bizarre to come in.
Would you come in, please?
All right, come on. Let's go in, huh? Nana? It's Bizarre.
Sit down, please.
Thanks.
Well, let's see now. Do you still wish to go through with your divorce action?
Yes.
Yes, definitely, I do.
Now, are you sure? Is there any element of doubt in your mind, either moral or practical or religious, and above all, financial?
No.
No, not at all.
Clerk, do you have that?
Yes, sir, I do.
Then ask Mrs. Bizarre to come in.
All right.
Look,
what's the matter?
Easy, take it easy. Calm down. Sit down.
Before granting a divorce, I have to attempt a reconciliation. We must try to preserve the unity of the family. That's the law.
Oh, I know it's the law, but he doesn't realize that I could pass out on his desk any minute now.
Come in, Mrs.
Oh, my God, there she is. Oh, God.
Won't you sit down?
I won't look at her. It's the only way I'll get through this. That perfume. Always the same one. Son of a bitch. Oh, God, I'm going to be sick.
What's the matter now? Haven't you been listening?
Yes, sir.
I'll read aloud those parts of the divorce law which pertain to your case. Where were we? In the event the parties refuse to be reconciled, the presiding judge shall, after consultation with the legal counsel, draw up...
That's funny. Maybe I'm cured. What if I tried looking at her? Nothing. Nothing happens. I can look at her. There she is. Maria Rosa in person. A witch. I can hardly believe there was once a time when I didn't even know she existed. And to think that I passed by that pharmacy almost every day. What was it? Chance? Destiny? Or the mysterious role that coincidence sometimes plays in our lives? What attracted me most about her was her walk, a combination of sensuality and modesty, as if she were in a harem in a church at the same time. Jealous as hell. They all gave you the air, or thought they did. But the truth is, I got them to walk out on me. And afterwards, I always said much better this way. Face it, Alfredo. You're scared of responsibility in everything. Top of your class in architecture, and what did you do with it? Excuse me, I'm almost certain that these stocks will go up tomorrow, but I can't take the responsibility. It's for you to decide.
All right, you can buy. That's right, buy.
Yes, thank you. All right, buy. Thank you. I work in a bank. Oh, just temporarily, I thought. But I'm still here. Permanent safe deposit. The counter. It's a barricade protecting me from the crowd. Because people have always frightened me a little. Yes, people frighten me. For years, Oreste and I used to spend our weekends going for long hikes in the mountains. He was my only friend. Even though we were the exact opposites of one another, he never said no to a good thing. Much better this way. Not him. I lived with my father. We got along fine. Oh, thanks, Papa. We led a very quiet life. Nothing special. And right out of the blue, why did that girl suddenly have to come barging into my life? Here's my chance. All I have to do is go over and help her pull down the screen. Nothing to it. It's easy. Yes, it was easy.
Alfredo.
Oh, ciao, Oreste.
What the hell are you doing here?
Oh, I'm waiting for a tram.
They went out of service in 47.
Oh, so that's why I haven't seen one.
Hey, you out of your mind? Eh? I'll give you a lift. I'm on my way to the hospital.
No, don't bother, ciao. I'll call you later. Oreste, I
later.
Changed my mind. No, take me home.
To the rescue! Et voilà.
Didn't I say there was nothing to it?
Alfredo, don't just stand there. Come on.
For a moment, I hated Oreste for his nerve. I felt humiliated. And I was scared stiff she'd spill the beans and tell about the clumsy way I shadowed her. But all she said was...
Pleased to know you.
My pleasure. Pleasure. It was obvious she hadn't even noticed me. Oreste. He's done it again. With her, too. But this time he's really bugging me. Just look at him. I can't get a word in edgewise. Come on, Alfredo, say something. Don't make an ass of yourself with her, too. What does she want? Why can't she keep her mouth shut? Yes, so she's got a cat. What do I care about her damn cat? No, it's no use. She doesn't even see me. Wow, is she beautiful. But he's stolen it right from under my nose.
A pen. Now, here we are. I'll write it all out. The first one's the number at the office, and the second's the clinic, just in case I'm there. Call and say, Maria Rosa. I'll chloroform my patient and run to you.
I know the kind of guy you are. But look up, because I may just decide to give you a call one of these days.
You do that.
And you should give your number to John. Why don't you? Yes, go on. Thank you.
Hello?
How are you?
Fine, but who's calling?
What are you doing tonight?
Who's calling?
Yes.
Oh, yes, of course. How's your cat? I'm sorry, I didn't think you'd phone in. I've already made plans for tonight. Mm-hmm.
Are you sure you aren't making a mistake? This isn't Jana, you know.
It isn't? Maria Rosa.
Was that so difficult? Hello? Hello?
Yes.
Are you still busy tonight?
Yes, I... No, I'm not. Why?
I couldn't believe it. Maybe it wasn't true. Maybe there was something behind it I couldn't understand. Or was she playing a joke on me? No, it was no joke. It's her. Here she comes. That confident smile of hers, that walk, that provocative walk that drives me right up the wall.
Why didn't you recognize my voice when I called now?
First thing I know, I'm in the wrong. A favorite tactic of hers, as I was to learn later. But how could I know that at the time? All I knew then was, oh God, she's clinging to me now. It's incredible. It's me she wants, not Oreste.
Oreste? Oh, no. You know, he's an example of the type of man I've always detested. Cynical and so conceited. When he looks at you, he makes you feel he's undressing you or worse. Alfredo, you're so different. You didn't even have the courage to come up to me.
Then you did notice me.
Of course I did at once.
I was very ridiculous, wasn't I?
Yes.
What's wrong?
But you were so tender, too. So moving.
And I'm floating on top of the world. In a daze. From our first day to our second, 8 o'clock sharp at the same place. 8:20. 8:35. 8:45.
You're here?
Aren't you getting in?
But how come you're... I didn't think you were coming. I thought that I made a mistake. I called my father just in case I called. I mean, you called.
Do you know that I've been watching you since you got here? Yes, I was absolutely right about you. Thank you. Thank you.
What for?
There are lots of ways a man can act when his girl's late. Thank you.
But meanwhile, I wonder, what's going on in that head of hers? What does she want? Does she want me to take her to bed or not?
No!
Maybe she does. After all, she called me. But what if I'm wrong? I watch her as the doctor undresses the head nurse. What'll I do? Do I or don't I? Do I kiss her or not? It's our third date, and it's almost over. Do I? No. Yes, I do. I do. I'll count to five, and then I'll kiss her. One, two, three. I can always apologize later. Four, four and a half.
It's late, isn't it? No, no. No, please, I can't. No. No, please. Oh, yes. Hello? Just a minute. Bizarre! It's for you.
Hello.
Hello, is this Mr. Alfredo's Bizarre Farmer Savings Bank?
Yes, speaking.
I have a telegram for you, sir. Shall I read it to you?
Yes, please.
It reads, forgive me, forgive me, forgive me, forgive me, forgive me, forgive me.
Yes, yes, I understand. Go on, please.
Forgive me, forgive me, forgive me, forgive me, forgive me, forgive me, forgive me. Stop. I love you, 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 I love you. That's a total of 17, forgive me, 25, I love you. Signed, Maria Rosa. Only one.
Yes, thank you, thank you.
Congratulations, sir.
Yes, thank you, thank you.
Thank you. I mentioned it.
I didn't even have to lie. I just said I had to run over to the pharmacy. Well, thank you, thank you. Me too, me too. Me too.
Didn't that order of vitamin E pills arrive?
Your prescription. We'll have it ready tonight.
Oh, thank you.
Think of Maria Rosa 100 times a day, before and after meals. Take a double dose at bedtime.
The second letter reached me at the bank 40 minutes later. It was a heart filled with words.
You're good, you're dear, you're sweet, you're handsome, you're tender, you're kind, you're honest, you're pure, you're mine.
The average soon became 4-5 letters a day.
Alfredo, there's a letter for you.
Well, thanks, Papa.
This was the third letter my father gave me within 48 hours. He never asked me anything, but I could tell he was excited. He sensed I was involved in something big for the very first time.
I am thy goddess. First, thou shalt worship no goddess but me. Second, thou shalt sanctify the day thou didst meet me. Third?
That's funny. All the commandments were there except the sixth, the one about fornication. How do I interpret that? Was it to encourage me to try and kiss her again or not? When in doubt, abstain.
Bye now. I'll be calling you soon, all right?
When
I feel like it. Ciao.
Well, maybe I shouldn't have abstained.
Darling, we absolutely must face up to the one thing that spoils our relationship, my phone calls. This is very serious. Whenever I call you, I get the feeling you don't love me as much. Where are you? What are you doing?
Where do you think I am? I'm in the bank, working.
I know you're in the bank, working.
I called you.
Yes, yes.
I want to know everything about you. Everything. Are you at your desk or at the main counter now?
Right now, I'm busy. I'll call you back, huh?
There's one thing I must tell you. If I have to talk to you, I'll call you, even if you're in a meeting with the manager of the bank. Where are you? What are you doing?
I'm with the manager, madam, in a very important meeting.
We're much more important, don't you understand?
Yes. Yes, of course.
What are you wearing?
Clothes.
The brown or the black suit?
The first.
What color tie do you have on?
Yes.
Yes, go ahead.
Well, I think perhaps it would be better if I called you later, madam.
Don't bother. Go to hell.
Yes, thank you. Thank you. And the same to you. Mm-hmm. No, I have it, Papa. I'm putting in phone plugs all over the house. Good night, sorry. Hello?
Hello.
Oh, ciao.
What are you doing?
Oh, as usual, I am standing in the hall.
Were you asleep?
Was I asleep? No, I wasn't sleeping. I was reading. What's the matter? Are you crying?
Yes.
Why, another bad dream?
You volunteered to go to war.
Volunteered?
Where? What war?
Any old war. I just couldn't stop you from going. I watched you get on the train with all the other soldiers. It was awful.
Oh, listen, listen. Luckily, there's no war, so stop worrying, please.
Christ, this girl really does have a sixth sense. I'm not going to war, but I am going to the mountains with a rest day on Sunday, that's for sure. But how can I tell her?
What makes you think I'd be unhappy?
Are you sure?
I wouldn't want to deprive you of anything that gives you pleasure.
But what will you do?
Alfredo, you go and have a nice time. I mean it. Oh, here. If you want to, you can phone.
From the mountain?
Well, if you called me, it would keep me company. I'll spend the day alone. I'll be near the telephone, counting the minutes till you call. Alfredo, why don't you kiss me anymore?
Is it possible?
Tickets. Thank you.
May I use the telephone?
No, it's a service phone for up there.
Oh. Is there a phone higher up?
It's a service phone down here.
For Christ's sake, who do you have to phone now?
Something had been bothering me for days now. How to tell Oreste I'd taken Maria Rosa away from him. Like a coward, I waited till he was stuck in his cage, 40 feet ahead of me, before I stabbed him in the back with it. That's so I wouldn't see how badly he took it.
I'm sorry!
Well, I'm not. She's a cow.
I beg your pardon!
I said she's a cow!
And all the while, I was obsessed with the thought of Maria Rosa stuck at home, waiting for my call.
Say hello for me, huh? And tell her you have my wholehearted approval.
I hope she doesn't answer. Maybe she's going to the movies.
Hello?
Damn it, not even one ring.
Oh, hello, Maria Rosa. I'm sorry.
Why didn't you call earlier?
Oh, well, I know you're right, but I...
Alfredo, you promised me.
Oh, I know, but I told you it wasn't going to be easy.
If you wanted to call, you'd have found some way.
Oh, are you angry with me?
No, just disappointed. I never believed you'd go in the first place.
Oh, but it was you who insisted that I go.
Well, that's precisely why you should never have gone.
I'm afraid that I didn't understand. Excuse me.
No, excuse me. I'm sorry.
Sorry? Why?
Yes, sorry I exist, that's all.
But... Hello, hello?
Hello? Maria Rosa?
I promised to spend Sunday with her, but on Wednesday she had one of her prophetic dreams. Then on Friday an aunt died, one who lived in the country. So on Saturday she had to leave.
Well, I won't be able to call you tomorrow. My uncle would be unhappy if I made any calls. Huh? I found a way to keep you company even though I won't be here. Not now. I want you to swear you'll open it first thing in the morning when you awake.
Yes, of course.
No, no, no. Swear now.
Cross my heart, I swear.
Good morning, darling. It's a beautiful day, isn't it? Now go to the pharmacy at the hospital. It's always open. Ask for Dr. Silvestri. Tell her I sent you and she'll give you something. See you soon. I love you.
Oreste. I told him to go ahead. I'd join him later in my own car. But I knew I'd never get there. Because by now I'd begun to catch on to this romantic gimmick of hers for keeping me close to her, even while we were apart. The third message ended all doubt in my mind. In each link of this love chain, I had to find the clue to the next hiding place. 74, 75, 76, 77, 78. Ah, there it is. I was caught up in a sentimental wild goose chase, running, searching, trying to solve riddles, puzzles, brain twisters, cryptograms.
Here you are.
Thank you.
My darling, while you're enjoying your lunch, think about G2.
Now, what the hell is this G2? I wonder now if I'm doing all this only because I'm afraid of what Maria Rosa would say if I didn't do it. No. I don't think so. I'm doing it because I like it. I'm doing it like she did it, with love. But damn it, I'd like to know what on earth G2 is.
Sotto la gronda della torre antica, una rondine amica.
The captain's tower, 284 steps. Destroyed by Barbarossa. Rebuilt even higher and more beautiful than before by the holy monks. Damn their souls. Who's tired? I'm not tired.
If you weren't tired hiding them, why should I be finding them? You have a letter for me.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's right. But... well, you're going to have to wait another 3 minutes, you know.
Listen, let me have it now. I'm tired. I've just been bitten by a dog.
Yeah, but... all right.
Thank you.
Darling, you've reached the treasure. Turn around.
My treasure.
I wonder if you thought about me today.
Oh. Oh. Your suitcase.
That night, I was so exhausted I fell into a restless sleep. But for once, I too had a dream. How prophetic it was, I couldn't tell.
Hello.
Where are you? What are you doing?
I'm sitting on the toilet making a caca. Oh.
I couldn't blame it on the fever. I had no fever. But the next day, I skipped work and my date with Maria Rosa. I'd rather sit here and think about her, about myself, about a relationship and the importance and weight it's taking on. Now, why did I say weight? I must try to understand the nuances. I read her letters over and over. They're so beautiful, so filled with love and tenderness. They're almost embarrassing. Well, maybe there are too many of them, but that's no reason for... Just look at her. She's so beautiful. I asked myself once and for all, what would my life be like now without Maria Rosa? The silence of this house?
Here you are.
Papa talking to the dog while he gets dinner ready. The milkman delivering the milk every day at the same time.
Hello. Is Alfredo home?
Yes, he is. Please come in.
You're his father.
Yes, I'm not late. Alfredo, there's someone here to see you. Quiet, Billy. Go into the kitchen.
come in.
Ciao.
Ciao.
How are you? I heard you weren't feeling well.
Oh, no, I'm much better. Sorry, Papa, I don't think you've met...
Oh, of course we have. I told her I wasn't the maid. I was your papa, Alfredo.
Oh, yes, these are for you.
Oh, that's very nice of you. Thank you. Please, why don't you come in? Please do. Alfredo, well, aren't you going to offer the young lady a drink? You are, aren't you?
Of course, Papa, but...
Ask her if she could stay to dinner with us.
Oh, no, thank you.
I want you to know I do the cooking myself.
Oh,
nothing
sorry,
fancy.
I can't.
Well, Alfredo, you convince her. Excuse me.
Please sit down. Would you like something?
Whatever you have.
Oh, we have everything.
Well, then, I won't have anything.
My father would be very pleased if you stayed for dinner.
And do you care if I stay to dinner?
Well, but why do you say that?
I don't know. Last night I really had the strangest dream.
What dream? Huh?
It doesn't matter. At least now I've seen you in your own house. I'll be able to think about you a little more clearly. So I wonder if it's worth it now.
Oh, please, what's wrong with you? I mean, what have I done wrong now?
Alfredo, where do I stand with you?
Stand, but...
Yes. On your scale of values, where do I stand with you?
It's very...
Just a second. If your papa and I were both going to die and both needed the transplant of a new kidney... Who would you give your kidney to?
My kidney?
Tell the truth now. Who would you give it to?
to my papa.
Oh, I knew it.
Oh, that I have to. I mean, everyone knows you only give your kidneys to your relatives. Where are you going? I was only kidding. I'll give you one each. Oh.
But what were you doing when I arrived here?
I was reading your letters.
And I thought that... Oh, darling, I'm sorry.
It's all right.
Please kiss me.
Kiss? No, I mean, I might have the flu. You could catch it. Oh. Maria Rosa, please, my father.
Stop it! Stop it!
What's going on?
Oh, it's nothing, Bob. It's nothing. One should learn to control one's emotions or not be so emotional, huh?
You know better than I thought. I should have believed those dreams. They were right.
So are mine.
Suddenly, I was terrified that I'd lost her forever.
Maria Rosa. Excuse me, Papa. Maria Rosa, wait.
I run after her like a madman. She doesn't stop, so I do. Dead in my tracks. Something holds me back. The same old story. Much better this way. This time, too. First night, I feel awful. I toss and turn and can't get to sleep. I feel just as bad the next day. I can't even do my work.
That's enough out of you. Look out!
On a third day, I begin to realize that a man has certain defense mechanisms which prevent him from thinking of the same person 24 hours a day.
Hello? Hello!
I'm tired.
Nothing. Only a deathly silence, broken by a sigh of pain. Then a click. They'd hung up.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Hello.
If we hurry, we can still get to the airport.
Yeah, we got about 15 minutes. Let's go.
Look out, behind you.
Stop or I'll shoot. Go!
No!
Son of a bitch, did they kill a vegetarian, huh?
Fourth day wasn't too bad, except around 2 o'clock when I thought I caught a glimpse of... No. Then, when I get home, there's another of those mysterious phone calls.
Hello.
Hello. Who is it?
I don't know. It's like someone who's suffering. It seemed as if he was drowning, Alfredo.
Oh, come on, Papa. Since when does a drowning man telephone?
Oh, well, you always know best.
Hello. Maria Rosa, is that you? Maria Rosa. If it's you, speak up, say something. Look, if you want, I'll come right over, but I can't go on like this. Please, say something, or I swear I'll pull out the plug. What is it now?
Hey! Where is it?
Hey, did they cut off your telephone? Don't waste time now. Get dressed. Hurry.
Don't move. I'll be right there.
Hurry, we're late.
Okay.
I recall that last Sunday in the mountains with great nostalgia. But I didn't realize I was saying goodbye to my freedom. I can still see myself with my friends sitting in the grass under a blue sky. We were happy without a care in the world as we ate, drank, and joked together. And then coming back bone tired, but at peace with the world after spending a memorable day.
Maria Rosa is my fifth child. She mustn't die. We've already buried our other children. She mustn't die.
Excuse me.
You might say we've been lucky. But really, Alfredo, you must have realized the girl was head over heels in love with you. You be nice to her now. Hey, Casanova.
Forgive me. So here I am, officially engaged to Maria Rosa.
and introduced to the intimate and gruesome secrets of the family. Four brothers killed in the war. The dusty souvenirs of years spent in the colonies. And the Friday night dinners when we were served fresh fish from the Adriatic, obtained through devious channels by my future father-in-law.
Caught today at dawn.
The very thought of those fish heads still makes me stutter. I felt I was in an ogre's den, and they were sucking out my eyes, my brain, everything. And this was the anteroom leading right to my marriage. Why had I gone this far? Was it just my innate cowardice?
Three coffees.
Three coffees?
Yes, in one cup, please.
All in one, sir?
Yes.
Oh, my God. My God.
I want to use the payphone. Spent the whole night long crying. In the morning, we finally convinced her. But then she began crying all over again. She tore off her veil, got completely undressed, and went right back to bed. Says she's frightened, still a baby. Hmm. I tell you, I'm at the end of my wits. Would you please try?
Right.
What about the bridegroom? Late too, I suppose. Where is Alfredo?
All of a sudden, Maria Rosa appears to me in a new light. The very fact that both of us were going through the same crisis suddenly made her more dear to me now than ever before.
Stood up at the altar on your wedding day.
Lucky break for you.
It's Alfredo.
Yeah. Hold on. Alfredo.
Don't be a fool. Take time to think. Put it off.
Alfredo, you talk to her.
Oh, if I'd only listened, warning after warning sent from heaven. But what use are they to us when we don't pay attention to them anyway? I begged, I pleaded. Later, when my father-in-law realized that he had forgotten to bring the wedding rings, it was I who rushed to the rescue again. And then, when the priest, due to some mysterious, almost providential clerical error, asked me...
Alfredo's bizarre. Do you wish to take as your own and legitimate bride the here present Giuseppe Antonelli according to the rites of the Roman Catholic
Church? I didn't bang my fist down and cry out, no, I don't want to marry Giuseppe Antonelli or anyone else. I'm getting the hell out of here. No. I just knelt there like a sentimental fool, waiting to pronounce the fatal.
Yes.
Maria Rosa Cavarani, do you wish to take as your own illegitimate husband, the here present Alfredo Spiza, according to the rites of the Roman Catholic Church?
Yes.
Later that evening, the thought occurred to me, if I really had married Giuseppe Antonelli, our wedding night might have been a little embarrassing, but much, much less complicated.
No!
Well, I started wrestling with Maria Rosa right after Mantua, and only made it as we hit the Cantagallo tunnel.
Out of the way, please. Open the door! Open up!
I'd rather skip all the explaining I had to do and my embarrassment and shame. All I can say is this became the pattern of our married life.
Quiet down, Willie. Quiet. That's a good boy.
Oh, thanks.
Quiet, Willie. Everything's all right. It's all right. Willie, be quiet. Keep quiet.
Just stand there. Get on with your work.
Go on. Go back to work. Be quiet or I'll find a new dog.
Maria Rosa has left her job at the pharmacy and now devotes herself entirely to me and to our home. She hires new servants and pursues them relentlessly, yelling at them, accusing them. My father and I are caught up in the hurricane.
No, no, that's not the way. I'll do it. Give me the flower.
The what?
The flower! Oh, no, out of the kitchen. You just get in my way. I can't stand people looking over my shoulder.
Right.
I'm nervous enough as it is.
I beg your pardon.
Down, down. I just cleaned. I'm not surprised our servants quit after working here for a week. That dog sheds its coat all over the house and he smells. I know you're used to it, but it makes me feel like growing up.
So Willie ends up in the cellar, just like when Mama was alive, while the cyclone rages on, overwhelming us. The first servant goes, the second and the third one, too. A merry-go-round of new faces begins, always ending with the same operatic finale. I remember an Elda, an Elsa, a Tina, a Rosaria, a Georgia, a Sandra, a Katerina. Until one day, coming home for lunch, I find the house immersed in silence.
Rita! Anybody home?
Get her.
Papa!
Oh. Where's Maria Rosa?
She's gone out. Didn't say where.
And Rita?
Clara.
No, I mean Clara.
She walked out on us this morning. She had a little row with Maria Rosa.
Aren't we eating today?
From now on, box lunches. I'm tired of training in competent service. Here you are. The delicatessen has all the food you want.
And so from that day on, Maria Rosa goes from frenzied activity to complete and utter indifference. No one dusts anymore. No one cooks for us. The house becomes a pigsty. And Papa and I venture back into the kitchen.
What do you say?
It's already after two.
You know, I think a little spaghetti with sauce might taste good right now.
Oh, I'm sorry, Papa. I'm really ashamed.
Yeah, no, that's silly. You know, women have their caprices. They like to keep you guessing. That's what makes them so fascinating, eh?
Fascinating, huh? But when I got up the next morning, Papa was gone. He had taken his clothes, his books, the dog, and had silently crept away to his little house in the country. Because as he said in his letter, young people must live alone and make their own happiness. Why do I suddenly feel afraid? Afraid of Maria Rosa? Why? Day and night. Night and day. Together, always. The only diversion I have left is Oreste, but my weekend passes are harder and harder to get.
is it?
Alfredo, if you don't mind.
Yes.
Yes, Sue, but I thought we'd agreed he'd call you once a month now.
It is a month.
Ciao, Resti.
Ciao. Weren't sleeping, were you?
No, 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 not at all, not yet.
Went to the mountain Sunday.
Sunday?
Yeah, Sunday.
Sunday. Wait, I don't know. Maybe Sunday.
Bet you can't guess who this is.
Huh?
Who am I? Guess who?
Best piece in Italy.
Oh, you're really a bad boy. I think I'll tell Alfredo, huh?
The hell you will.
Now, what about Sunday?
Going to the mountains?
Yes, I know.
I asked Alfredo.
Yes, I know. Would you mind very much if I were to go?
No.
Do you mean I can't ever go with you to the mountains on Sunday?
Well, no,
am I wanted, yes or no?
You still remember my telephone number, eh?
She also knows a plumber's phone number by heart, too.
That's not true. I found it in an old purse. Oh, I don't trust you.
There you go. Good girl. You too. That's how help you are. Come on, I'll do it all alone. Up we go. That's the girl.
We made it, huh?
Maria Rosa. Maria Rosa, did you hurt yourself?
No.
Hey, little wine?
Franco, where's the wine?
Come on, give it back.
Maria Rosa. Here, have a drink.
No, leave me in peace, huh?
What's eating her? She's mad at him, I guess.
But why?
You're the one who should know.
I'll talk to her.
No, no, Alfredo, not you. You'll just make it worse. I'll go. I'm better at it.
Maria Rosa, why don't you come over and sit with us? Huh? Come on.
You bastard! Who do you think you are? Now you get away from me!
Maria Rosa.
Hey!
You're an idiot.
Maria Rosa, what
is it? Some friend you have. Some friend. I hate you.
What's the matter?
Let's get into her. What the hell's wrong?
Maria Rosa, what did you say to her, huh?
Oh, nothing.
Go on. Ask your best friend what he said.
What I said? Your wife's out of her mind.
Oh, no. Maria Rosa, wait. Don't you think that I know you? Always. You were always like that. But at least not with my wife, you fuck. Maria Rosa!
You think I give a hoot about your damn wife? Go on. Run after her. Just look at her. Big, strong husband. Malafanculo, you hear? Both of you.
Malafanculo to you, too! Maria Rosa!
We're both happier when we're alone, aren't we? Just the two of us.
And so, with the painful feeling of having been unfair to him, I lose Oreste, my oldest and only friend. I remember that around this time, a strange rash appeared all over my body, one that I'd never had before. Red blotches with even redder blistering pimples on top. I had no idea what could have caused them.
Could be food poisoning. Maybe had some bad fish.
I haven't eaten fish for the last 6 months. Good or bad.
Listen, it's that crazy woman they called yesterday.
Well, the number's ringing. Let's hope MR is at home.
Just listen to this nut.
Hello?
Ah, good morning, madam. It's a beautiful day, isn't it?
Well, maybe it is to you, but I haven't had a beautiful day since I got married.
Oh, well, madam.
Yes?
We know that you're having to face up to some really difficult problems. That's why we've called in Dr. Roberti, our staff psychologist. Perhaps he can be of help.
Good morning, madam. Now, what exactly is your problem?
Well, I just can't seem to make any sense out of my marriage.
Well, you're not the only one. A number of eminent psychologists have written that the institution of marriage makes no sense.
Is that supposed to be funny?
I was only trying to help you, madam.
It isn't funny to wake up one morning and find that you've married a mediocre little man. A nothing. An absolute nothing.
I feel sorry for that little jerk.
He's actually crying.
Is there anything wrong, sir?
No, I completely forgot I have an appointment.
Why didn't you let me finish? You can say with the barber.
I'm tired of giving, giving, giving all the time.
Wait till I get there. I'll give you something.
I give it. He gives me nothing. I love him, and he just lets himself be loved.
Excuse me, madam, for being indiscreet, but I must have a full case history. Your sexual relations, are they normal?
No!
No! Doctor, please help me. What can I do?
Well, madam, have you and your husband ever considered using the oldest remedy in the world?
Maria Rosa! Maria Rosa! Where are you? Still warm. Maria Rosa! Maria Rosa! Open the door! Open the door or I'll break it down!
I want a baby, Alfredo. I want a baby now. Please don't make me wait anymore. Please, darling, I know that it's the oldest remedy in the world, but it's the right one. What good is a woman if she doesn't feel that she's a mother?
Of course she's right, poor darling. Come to think of it, I like children, too. At least I think I do. Raising them, watching them grow up, hear the little voices around the house, rediscover with them one's own youth, the joy of being alive.
Tell me that you want us to have a baby too.
I do. I never did anything to prevent it, did I?
That's just what's been bothering me. It's 6 months, you know it. Alfredo, I'm sure I can have children. That's what worries me. Alfredo, it's you who must be sterile.
And so the reason I'm here, Doctor, is my wife is anxious to know if I'm sterile. And as a matter of fact, I would like to know, too.
Your wanting to find out is quite understandable. I get this type of question all the time now. We can easily examine your fluid, your seminal fluid. Here we are. Here. When you've done it, use this little buzzer. All right?
Done what?
Now, really. Here's a book you can look at. It might give you a little inspiration.
Give me some satisfaction, morally, I mean, because as it turned out, I was perfectly healthy, and it was Maria Rosa who had a little problem. In order to get pregnant, she had to undergo treatment, which included a certain routine carefully prescribed by the gynecologist.
2 pills just before bedtime. Intercourse. Once or several times a day, to be done when you're most fertile, which is between 10:30 and 11:30 a.m.
in the morning.
And or from 2:30 to 5 o'clock.
It has to be during office hours.
Well, you'll have to ask for permission, that's all.
I asked for time off 2, 3, 4 times. My excuses became less and less convincing. And then I started running out of excuses. Well, here it is, sir. You can read it yourself. As you can see, it is a very delicate matter. May I ask you for your maximum discretion, sir? Sir?
Huh? Oh, yes, yeah, sure.
Who orders a double eggnog, double sugar?
A double eggnog for Visa.
Drink it now and have your fun.
Afternoons between 3 and 5 o'clock, with the rash on my back itching me more than ever, I suddenly realized that I hated her. Yes, I hate her. I hate her. I told her my father was sick and I got 2 days off.
Alfredo! It's ready! You like it, pork stew!
I didn't explain why I was there, and he didn't ask me. Maybe so as not to upset me, or maybe not to be upset himself. Like all furloughs, it came to an end too soon. And I had to return to the front lines.
Alfredo! Yeah, come on. Come on.
Alfredo! Oh, you're wonderful. Bravissimo.
I'm a grandfather. At last, you did it, son. Come on, come on.
I assumed I was a father. Wasn't quite clear, though. Who the hell was that gypsy walking around my house?
Pretty Fisa. Why do you giggle all the time? Can't you ever be serious? I think it's frightening. Now, what did I just tell you? Please, it's not funny. Repeat it now.
A casar vos dos nella seconda camera. A casar quello con su roba nel sotano.
Now, where did she learn to talk that way? He's the boss, you know, and he pays you. Vaya, 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 vaya.
You won't pay her too much. She's straight from the mission. You don't want to spend what it costs for a real servant, do you?
Yes, yes, it's all right. It's all right. But what does sotano mean?
The situation is difficult, you know. The doctor said that her pregnancy won't be very easy. For a period of 2 months, Maria Rosa will have to sleep alone. She mustn't move. Not even an eyelid. You get the idea, Alfredo?
Sure, sure.
We all have to make sacrifices now. My wife and I are moving into your father's room to help Maria Rosa. But now where does that leave you? You want to tempt her by staying near her when she has to rest now?
No, wouldn't dream of it. But what the hell is this sotano? Is it the sofa, the living room? Please translate.
Why, it's that marvelous little apartment you got on the ground floor. It's dry and it's got its own entrance from the garden.
He meant the cellar. Sotano in Spanish, which also meant basement. Anyway, that's what we always called it. Well, that's all right. Everything's all right as long as they leave me in peace. I bring down my things, my books, my mountain gear. In fact, all that really belongs to me in that house, now under enemy occupation. I also rediscover long forgotten things.
Moniti de lui.
Ah, yes, but this is many years ago.
Moniti me gusta.
Oh, thank you. Come to think of it, Crucifisa was right. They weren't bad at all. I got the urge to paint again. I found my old easel and set it up, bought some oils and began again. I wonder why the first thing I painted were seagulls in flight. Ah, I was really enjoying myself.
Vola colomba bianca vo.
There is an enormous treasure buried on the island of Monte Cristo.
Excuse me, I'm a little tired. I think I'll go downstairs.
Well, you're in the way.
I will soon be at peace in the arms of our Lord.
Father, don't say that, please.
Count Spada named you as a soul.
Even further from the house, to the door of the cafe in the piazza. No, nothing. No one had missed me. The truth is that at this stage, I don't exist for her. She doesn't need me. The third evening, I go as far as the main street and into a bar.
One cognac for Vassé.
Thank you, Doc. A toast to my secret rediscovered freedom. Some freedom. You know what you can do with it with all those pimples. Oh, God, my hair. I'm starting to lose my hair. The only thing I had. I've had it. I'm through. In memoriam.
Excuse me, sir, but for a moment you made it look as if you were going to wash your hair with a cognac.
Oh, I see. So you were laughing at me.
No, I didn't laugh at you, but it was funny.
How much is this hair lotion?
Oh, it's 800 lira. Thank you, call again.
Oh, I'll be seeing you tomorrow evening. I start looking around me again. I start eyeing the girls in the street, even those who bump into me. And I have to admit that once in a while, the girls notice me too. Then there's Nora, the scalp therapist at the clinic I've been going to the past few months. I see her smiling at me from the mirror, and we get to be friends in an atmosphere of spring and reawakening, in which even Crucifisa takes part.
Par compagnie, felicidad.
Oh, thank you.
Of course, flowers too. Why not? They remind me of my father and his gardening. So I go out and buy seeds, bulbs, garden tools, and I start digging, planting, and watering.
Da 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 da.
Huh. When you know it, up in headquarters, these new hobbies of mine were not at all appreciated. But who gives a damn? Anyway, my pimples have disappeared. Well, almost. Since I've stopped sleeping with her. Then Maria Rosa began taking an hour's walk every day. Today is Sunday, and it's a beautiful day. I can't help thinking of the mountains and Oreste.
Have you heard from Oreste recently?
Hmm? No, I... She's reading my mind. A shudder runs through me. She's a witch from a race of witches. Yes, because my mother-in-law should be burnt at the stake. She gave me proof of it the other day when Maria Rosa...
Mama! It's nearly 12:30. What could have happened to Crucifisa?
I only wish the devil would take her off to hell right now.
Oh, come on. There she is now.
Anyway, to find the witches, I phoned Oreste the next day.
Hello? Guess who, doctor?
Alfredo's bizarre. What a surprise. You bring tears to my eyes.
How are you?
What's with your life? Did you strangle your wife?
No, no.
Then you poisoned your wife.
No.
Then you need help.
I suddenly wanted to see him again, to get together like in the old days, so I invited him to dinner.
No, not with her.
No, I swear.
I assured him there would only be the two of us. We arranged to meet Thursday evening at the Golden Grill. But that same day, I was taken by surprise by something Nora said.
I guess if you were to invite me out to dinner one night, I know I wouldn't order anything with eggs in it.
You mean...
I got it.
You'd come to dinner with me?
Glad to. Just name the day.
Sure, I will. I'll invite you. When?
Well, tonight, for example, I'm free if you like.
So am I. Free? Free like hell. I was having dinner with Oreste that evening. I tried calling him to put it off, but couldn't find him. He was out on calls and wasn't coming back. What was I to do? Bring her along to dinner with Oreste? Two against one. No. I had an idea. Irene, the cashier at the bar, accepted immediately. In fact, she even went so far as to change her night off. Nora was sure that Irene was Oreste's date, and Irene vice versa. As for me, I couldn't care less. I was just excited for the first time I was bringing a date for Oreste.
Alfredo! Alfredo! It's good to see you again, you little bastard. You're looking great, just great.
But this time, too, he had brought one for me. There was nothing to be done. Oreste would always be Oreste. I was almost tempted to unload all four of him and get the hell out. But then, if I had, I would never have met Catalina.
It seems to me that you two screwed things up a bit. Oh.
Good evening, good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
How many, please?
Let's see now. 1, 2, 3, 4,
6,
five.
I think. Unless you've invited two or three other girls.
No. We just got our signals crossed, that's all. Anyway, better to have too many than to be alone. Me, I'm sitting here. Alfredo, at the head of the table. Take it away. It's too big. Alfredo, sit down. There we are, girls. 4 against 2. The choice is yours. Try to be fair. It's up to you now. Who would like to start?
I'll start.
Sit down.
Ooh. Wait.
Okay, me too. Why not? There's something special about Carolina. She's so alive and spontaneous. She seems to enjoy everything and everybody. She's like no one I've ever met before.
You and Oreste, are you very friendly?
Oh, no. He's one of my clients. I've just redone his garden.
Oh, you do landscaping.
Yes, I'm a landscape architect.
Oh.
Listen, if I give you a piece of my steak, may I have a stuffed olive?
Oh, please.
Thanks. Good.
Good. Wait, you order too?
No, I'd rather take them from you.
Why?
I don't know, because I like what belongs to others. Maybe I'm a little crazy. I was making a list the other day of all the men I'd ever been in love with, and guess what I found out?
What?
Well, I realized every one of them was married. Would you really mind if I had another one, huh?
I'm married.
Oh. You're married and you feel it.
Why, does it show?
No. I knew, though. I heard all about it from Oreste.
Mm.
Are things that bad between you and your wife? Mm. Rather not talk about it. Right? Mm. Then I won't. Can I have one more?
Mm.
What kind of hair lotion is that?
Oh, very special lotion. I use fresh eggs and pure butter. If you like them that way, it's yours. Yes, I like them that way.
Well, this is about the right season for planting flowers.
Oh.
Daffodils, roses, geraniums. Some of them flower all year round.
Mm.
Well, it depends on the sun, you know what I mean?
Mm. Oh, yes.
Do you have very much sun in your garden?
Oh, in the morning.
Bad luck. Listen.
Mm?
Why don't we go off on our own?
Oh, I wish we could.
Now, look. Why don't we go over to the nursery and have a look at the flowers? Just like that. We could get a little fresh air, too. You coming?
How?
Yes, why not?
But what about the others? How can we?
Get the others. Come on.
But the bill.
Oh, to hell with it. Now, these are called crotons. Aren't they beautiful? And over there are philodendrons. They're from the rhododendron family. I've got the most wonderful job in the world.
Yes, it is wonderful, but I can't see any flowers.
Oh, come on. You knew the flowers were just a pretext, didn't you?
Is it possible to kiss like this?
And better, too.
Only now, at the age of 35, I discover what it means to make love. It's divine, complete, profound. It's tenderness and peace. I still can't believe it's happening. And deep down, I keep waiting for the final scream. But instead... And I forget time, my duties as a slave, my fear of Maria Rosa. And I even forget she exists.
Thank you.
Three of us. Calm down.
Oh, Maria Rosa. Crucifisa. Darling, calm down.
Crucifisa. Bring the hot water.
Darling, everything will be all right. Please. A curse on you. May God strike you down.
Don't say it, Delfina. Don't say it.
If she loses the baby, it's all your fault. Do you hear that? Your soul will rot in hell.
Hysterical pregnancy.
Well, you know, it's not the...
Okay.
It's not the first time it's happened, but when it does, it's so convincing. No test, nothing can indicate it's not the real thing.
Mm. Then it'll take a long time before we can have intercourse again, won't it?
No, nothing of the sort. In a couple of days, your wife will be back to normal.
Back to normal? God, and Carolina. What about Carolina? Yes, back to normal. The TV set goes back to the living room, and I go back to TV. My marital pimples come back again and cover me from head to toe. My pajamas are back on the bed. And soon, all too soon, as the gynecologist said, Maria Rosa is back to normal. Wanted to shave a little before we...
Alfredo! Alfredo! Alfredo!
Carolina!
What are you doing here, Alfredo?
I ran away from home.
What is it now? Rather not talk about it, huh? Now, what are you going to do?
I don't know.
You have any ideas? You can't sit around here all day.
I can't go to a hotel or to my father's. She might find me there.
I know. Better if she calms down a bit. Let's look in my book and see what I've got to do today. Oh, who gives a damn? Come on.
Where to?
To my house. Okay?
Who's there?
Oh, my mother and father. It's all right.
Oh. Mama!
Mama, Papa, this is Alfredo, a friend of mine. Oh. He's staying with us for a couple of days. Then we'll see. Mama, would you make up the couch in my studio? But please hurry, won't you? He's been awake all night. Mama, he skipped out on his wife and he's going to have to hide out here. So what? Oh, excuse us. Oh, make yourself at home. Sit down. How do you do? Mama, where are the sheets? Oh, I'll show you. Excuse me.
Would you like to have some coffee?
Oh, no, thank you.
Oh, we'd like to have breakfast, Papa. Coffee and butter toast, huh?
Oh, excuse me.
Where's your suitcase?
Oh, I left it in the...
Well, it doesn't matter. I'll get it while you take your bath.
Oh.
Could you give me your number at the bank?
What?
There's a razor you can use. There must be a blade here.
The bank? Why?
Well, you'd better take a couple of days off, don't you think? I hear. Why, you want to go?
3250. What do you say?
You just take your bath, all right?
Huh?
The managing director, please. It's urgent.
Just a moment, please.
Oh, I wanted to let you know that Mr. Zvizar will be taking a few days' vacation.
What for?
To be with his family.
What do you mean? Who is this?
What a bore. All right, I'll tell you the truth. He skipped out on his wife and he's gone into hiding. Is that better? Oof.
Hiding?
What's that got to do with it? It's no business of the banks, huh?
What do you mean? Now, look here.
Well, he's a free man and he's made up his mind.
What an extraordinary creature. What an angel. In those 2 days, she devoted herself completely to me. She found an apartment in the old part of town and helped me move in and fix it up, transforming a poor runaway slave into a man still capable of being happy. Here with me. And still more wonderful, she'd always leave at the right moment. And I could stretch my legs in bed, alone at last. I listened to the silence, the music of being alone. It seems impossible to be so happy. And yet, it should be the easiest thing in the world. Never have imagined that those knocks on the door would be the beginning of years of persecution, 4 long years that would bring me to the rostrum addressing a meeting for the institution of the divorce law without even stammering. Me, yours truly, Alfredo Spiza. Is it fair to deny a man the right to a dignified life without being forced into hiding, without being pursued by the police who are at the service of his vindictive wife? Years, years of skulking, running, hiding, like common criminals. That's our real punishment, to have to love each other in hiding.
For some time, we'd had no news of Maria Rosa. Yes, my friends, incredible but true, we've made it.
A toast, ladies and gentlemen, to the real heroines of this tragedy, to the women who for years have been the innocent victims of slanderous gossip. And now may I make a personal toast to a lady who for over 14 years has been my companion, the companion of my life and the mother of my children, and whom the law which all of us fought for now allows me to marry, my companion and wife.
We want to hear Spiza.
Spiza!
Spiza!
Thank you.
Go on. Go on.
My friends, I think we lost one of our speakers. Maybe he's nervous because he's a bachelor again. Don't worry, darling, I'll take over for you. Anyway, I think it's all been said. Long live the Republic and long live marriage. What is it? Don't you want to talk to me?
Do you...
Oh.
Do you want to go home with me?
Huh? Oh, no, not tonight.
Why?
No, it wouldn't be in good taste.
Why?
Because they're all out doing it tonight.
Think so?
Sure.
You mean our chairman, too?
Oh, don't make me think of it. Take me home now, all right? Ciao.
Ciao.
See you tomorrow.
Carolina, what? Signorina, from the first moment that I met you, I knew that I could never live without you. It is out of this deep emotion that I humbly ask your hand.
Oh, you must realize how terribly sudden this is, Signor Alfredo. Well, I may need time to think about it.
May I at least hope?
There's nothing I can do to prevent that.
Ciao. The next morning, I woke up with my back itching me. Well, maybe I had too much to drink the night before. Hello?
Where are you? What are you doing?
Listen, don't you ever play those jokes on me again.
You fell for it, huh? But I wasn't kidding, you know. I'm starting to learn how to be a wife. That's right, I've decided to accept your proposal. I'm going to break the news to my father and mother by 2 sacks of the very best fish heads, and tonight we'll celebrate our engagement. 8 o'clock, be all right?
Okay.
Ciao, have to go.
Ciao. Good evening, Professor.
These are for you.
No.
Oh, but excuse me, Professor. They're Cuban.
How can you do this to us after all the sacrifices we've made for you? It isn't right.
Stop it, Mama, will you? I'm sick and tired of this Greek tragedy. It's all a farce, anyhow.
A mother who's trying to prevent her daughter from ruining her life. Do you call that a farce?
Oh, why go on and on?
And the things your father and I sacrificed to bring you up all these years, is that a farce?
Oh! Alfredo, sorry, we won't be eating here. Come on, I'll take you to a restaurant.
The plans and the hopes a mother has for her daughter.
Oh, I know what you would have wanted for me.
You think I want him for my son-in-law? A mediocrity who can't even earn a decent living. He's just a little bank clerk.
Will never amount to any good.
How can you respect him? A man capable of leaving his wife, and one day he'll be...
Look, when he was my lover, you didn't mind, but now he's no good.
We thought he was just a boyfriend.
Huh?
I swear we didn't know. If we thought you'd been to bed with him...
I think we better go.
Don't take her away from us, please.
Will you stop this, Mother?
She's all we have, huh? She's all we have.
You know, just as long as I stayed with them, they wouldn't mind if I became a lesbian. They'd say a prayer to Santa Anita.
Oh, she's a patron saint of, I comfort her. I try to cheer her up. I try joking with her to convince her things will work out in the end. Instead.
Go on sleeping. I'd like to see you when you awake. I'll make you regret what you did to your father and mother. After that, I bet you won't sleep anymore. Good night. Good night.
What could I do? I came here.
And you left her just like that?
No, I disinfected it with a bit of iodine.
But you can't leave her now. She might try again.
Oh, Alfredo, how naive. She only did it because I was there. Things have gone too far. Either I spend my life with them or with you. What do you think? Now, are you going to let me come in or aren't you?
Excuse me, I'm sorry. I didn't... I have to admit, she took me a bit by surprise. I watched Catalina empty all her things onto my bed. Underwear, dresses, shoes, stockings, like a wife back from a trip. I discovered that even things are of different sexes. They blend, unite, take on common habits, live side by side, wear each other out, and marry.
Well?
I've never seen you in a nightgown before. So now it's done. Maria Rosa and I are no longer husband and wife. It's all over, finished. Years of love, hate, war, bitterness. One goes this way, the other goes that way.
Carolina!
Well, it's all over with.
Oh, it is?
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Excuse me.
I have to go. Tell me, what was it like being here again?
Oh, my heart.
How does it feel to be free again?
Here I am again. Even if I'm in City Hall this time instead of in a church, and even if it's Carolina who's standing beside me, my sweet, dear Carolina, I feel the same drowning feeling I did the first time, the same urge to run away.
Do you, Alfredo Sbizza, wish to take as your lawful wedded wife the here present Carolina Bettini?
Yes.
And do you, Carolina Bettini, wish to take as your lawful
wedded wife? Say no, darling. At least you say no. I'm a coward, but you've always been so courageous. Tell the truth. I beg you, my love. Say no.
Yes.
Matrimoni benedetti, matrimoni sconsacrati, celebrati da preti, da sindaci annoiati. Matrimoni di rabbia, matrimoni d'amore, tutti finiti a rotoli fra lacrime e rancore. Ma sempre ci sarà sotto la luce del sole chi butta nella mischia un po' del proprio cuore. Così vuole la vita che guarda sempre avanti, in chiesa o in municipio, finiamo tutti quanti, tutti quanti. La rari rararua, rairi rararua. Matrimoni di rabbia, matrimoni d'amore, tutti finiti a rotoli fra lacrime e rancore.